or something is that? Do we really believe in that, or is it just like we know it, we have to stick to it?
Don't speak with each other when someone is speaking, and people still speak. So what is their belief? What do you think? So what did he say? That means if a teacher is speaking and that student is speaking, that means what your belief is, what you have to tell him is more important than what the teacher is saying. This belief that I don't have to be wrong when my turn comes.
So the belief under that can be that when I speak wrong, the other people will judge me.
Fantastic. So what is actually required is, if there is a behavior which is not good for the whole class, if this behavior is not good for the whole class, so the idea is we understand, okay, this is being caused because of this behavior, and if I do not want the class to be disturbed, if I want to learn from others' mistakes, then it's good to understand what my beliefs are. And who will change those beliefs? Me!
No time management. And what has been happening is, there is too much to do, we waste our time and do not use it productively. Laziness and lack of consistency. We believe that we have to accomplish a lot of work. We feel that accomplishing no task is good, whereas accomplishing less is not good. We believe that the task in hand is very time consuming. We believe we don't get enough time to enjoy.
When it's a belief, it will also become a reality, and when it's a reality, it will also become a reality. And it strengthens each other. And that's why we are not able to come out of it. But to some extent, or I would say to a very large extent, since we believe in that, it happens. And guess what? If we believe in the opposite, that also happens.
Every Wednesday during the energy project, there are two beliefs which we have stated in the iceberg, which is fear of mistakes. The second one is people are getting neglected. A belief under that is people think that they, under fear of mistakes is, people think they will always be wrong. A belief under that is whoever participates should be correct. A belief under that is we should never commit mistakes. And if people neglected, the belief is people prefer more experienced people. And people should always project a good image in front of themselves. Image of themselves.
Committing mistake is bad. Is that a belief? Or is that a fact?
It's both.
Both. So you have to always recognize it's both.
So but actually, you can't call it a fact, because mostly if you fail, then you know where mistakes actually are. Then you won't fail again.
Fantastic.
So that then you can't say that committing mistakes is bad. You have
very
to say
nice.
It's good.
See, now what is important is he speaking out of his experience, or is he speaking out of someone telling him this? You see the difference? So his parents have told him, no, committing mistake is good, you learn. That is what his dad is saying, but does he believe that? If that is his experience, what would be a fact for him? What would be a fact? What would he be looking forward to?
Committing
mistakes. Therefore, he will learn more. You see that? Therefore, the fact that this is a fact is very funny, because what I believe becomes a fact. You see this here right now.
You give yourself more opportunity to actually make mistakes, because you want to learn. Therefore, you will bring mistakes.
Right? And therefore, if suppose he is there, he has found out through experience that when I commit a mistake, I learn more. So he will look for more challenges, he will look for more risks in life. So he will take more risks. Why? Because he is not afraid of risks. Why? Because he has experience that he learns more. So it's him. Versus another boy, let's say him. He has experience that when I commit mistake, I was reprimanded. I was punished. So what has he learned from that?
Not commit mistakes.
Don't commit mistake. Therefore, he becomes less risk taking. And therefore, in life, if you don't take risk, you don't do great things. All big things, great things, you have to take small and big risks. So therefore, he won't be able to
take
risk. And what is the reason for that?
Because he didn't commit mistakes.
Exactly.
So he didn't know that from committing mistakes he learns. So that's why he didn't take risks in his life.
Suppose in a particular community or society, they all start believing like him that all mistakes are opportunities to learn. What will be a structure in that school? Let's say ideally in some hypothetical room there is a school where teachers, students, everyone starts believing that hey, mistake is good, I learn. What is that one structure? We are introducing the word structure.
Rule.
So what is that one rule which you will not see in that school? What do you think?
There will not be any punishment.
Fantastic. There will be no rules of punishment. But
you won't say, I was
that's
why. Were you that? So there won't be any punishment.
There won't be any punishment. So people will get to learn more. They'll not have a fear of committing mistakes, and therefore it can go in both the tracks. It can go in carelessness.
Fantastic. It can go into carelessness.
If people are feared of their mistakes, then only they'll do the work. Like if we have
to believe, is that a fact?
It's both actually. Can we believe
or not? Very nice.
That's
a lesson. So very nice. When the fear of punishment goes away, now we have a huge risk. Because now there is no punishment. So we could completely go off or we could completely become learners. Right? So if we have a structure where any mistake, it is not that mistake is forgotten or mistake is not talked about. In fact, in such a school, any mistake will become a topic of discussion. Okay, he has committed a mistake. Oh really? Let's see. What were the beliefs? What are we all learning about that mistake? So we all learn. If suppose that is the process, that's a structure, then what is likely to happen? We will all learn. We will all learn this is not good for all. And we do. Not because of the rule, not because of the punishment, not out of fear, but out of understanding.
We think that we want to be independent and we are old enough to take our own decisions. So the beliefs below that are we want to experience everything ourselves. Parents are concerned about us. We think we are grown up to take decisions. And there's a huge generation gap between parents and us. So that's why there is conflict between our thoughts.
But the parents have gone through this age and they think that they are right. They are too small to take the decisions, they are not right to be right.
What is the belief below this, just what you said? What is the belief below that? One of us has to be right and the other obviously has to be wrong. Is that the belief? Because only one can be right. Is that the belief? They also believe the same
thing.
That is why there is a conflict. Parents also believe that out of the two, only one can be right. And obviously, I will be right. If one has to be right, then it's me. is it possible that both beliefs, you know, that there is one more belief that both are right and both are wrong? Suppose the parents start believing that hey, both would be right and both would be wrong, and the children also start believing that both would be right, both would be wrong. Then what happens? Is there a conflict? Then there will be no conflict. So do you see the gap in the beliefs?
What is it? As the parent starts believing that,
the conflict may not end, but they'll be open to more ideas.
Fantastic. There is an opening for conversation. There is an opening for talking.
Why there is no opening? How many kids, how many teenagers are not able to speak freely with parents? How many? Almost all. And how many parents, you ask parents, how many of them are able to convey their ideas to children? Very few. What is the reason? Beliefs. What are the beliefs? I am right, you are wrong. And children's belief is also I am right here.
They don't always sense the entire thing. It's not something which happened with me, but I've been noticing it. Like, they don't tell us the entire thing. What's true? You have to do this, you have to do it.
You have to.
This why? Why not?
No argument.
And this is
and
not
what is the
belief
below that?
Children are too young, why do they have to understand?
There's no need to understand whatever, because when I had to work.
As a parent, what I would say is, I would say that my children don't know anything. They need to be guided over them.
What would it be that the parents fear that the children ultimately will get hurt?
That also.
Yes,
that also.
But doesn't it at the end again end to one point that they have always concerned about us?
Yes.
It's always been leading up to that one point.
That is there, but it doesn't help day to day, you know.
If the parent is concerned, that I know, but if they are not telling me, if I feel claustrophobic, it doesn't help.
There are certain reasons that parents do not tell the thing to the children, because they think that they are not at the age to understand.
But at least they can say this, that I believe you will not be able to understand because that's your age. Can they say that? No.
If sometimes they say the children are eager to know what's the belief, yeah.
And you were saying?
So it's like parents don't say this because they feel like if I say that they will judge, they get more of a wrong thing. It would affect them.
In the process of finding
out. That actually happens, so we fight.
But you can find out together, right?
I always make it a point to see my dad is saying you're not supposed to do this. We always talk at the dining room. I ask him why not. So at the end when he tells me, I do see the logic. But then still at times it happens that, yeah, even if he is right, but no. I can't do it.
Correct.
But there is a belief, so if you next time are able to have a communication that I still believe, my belief is like this, what is your belief behind what you're saying? So now this brings us to a nice story, so real life. So we were teaching systems thinking in a school called Bojali School, and then those kids like you, when you get used to, then you kind of insist that now you teach this to our parents. So we conducted a workshop for parents, and after that workshop one parent came and said, oh, you know, after the workshop, a few days, he called me up. He said, this whole thing has solved one big problem. So I said, what? He said, you know, we stay in one garden road, and we stay on this side of the road, and his little son, I think 5-6 year old, he has a friend on the other side of the road. So he would always tell him that I want to go and I want to bicycle with my friend, because they had a bigger one. Then he would refuse. He would say, nahi, maani. It is his son will get very irritated that why my dad is not allowing me to bicycle with my friend who lives on the other side. And this kept on for years, 1 or 2 years. And the son was absolutely annoyed with his dad. So when the father came for the workshop, so they learned this art of asking what you're doing. Right? So this son also learned, and he was a little older, 7 or 8. So when the son asked his father, what is the belief? Why you are not allowing me to play? Then the father told that child that actually I am afraid that if we cross the road, then some vehicle might hit you or something might happen. So you get hurt. That's why I am not afraid. This he did not tell him again. And the son said, oh, it is a problem. So you should have told me earlier. What we'll do is put the bicycle in your car dickey and you drive me across the road and drop me. That is the route we'll